All hail a beard, it's your boy Big BB, and we back for another edition of Big Beard Business. Today we're here with the fragrance review for a fragrance line that I've pretty much enjoyed from its launch. And this fragrance that I'm talking about comes from YSL, and this one is YSL YO Fresh. Now, here's the deal. This one is the fourth installment within this fragrance line, and I think this fragrance brings something a bit different to the game. Now, we're talking about this line in itself. Why the original one, I think that released back in 2017, if I'm not mistaken. This little guy here wasn't super well received. I think I remember like when this thing coming out, and I was out on a hunt for it, maybe within 3 or 4 days of this thing being on the market, I had somebody hit me up like, yo, B, I don't like it. I can ship it to you if you want it. I had just picked this thing up, so I thanked him obviously for, you know, the offer, but I had this one in collection. I began to smell it and I was like, yeah, and then I began to really enjoy this fragrance. Now, I know we're a bit off topic, but we're talking about Eau Fresh, but I think it will all make sense in the end. Now, this fragrance here, again, wasn't super well received. And I think one of the things about this fragrance, like many other fragrances out there that really had people upset or like, yeah, I'm not really feeling it, is that this thing is super, super synthetic. There's nothing that I can detect in this fragrance that is like really natural. This one has a super synthetic feel. Think of Azzaro Chrome. That one is super synthetic. Although these smell nothing alike, that is just super synthetic. Long story short, I really ended up liking this fragrance here. I talked about it a ton within the channel, and obviously I put a dent in it over the years. Now, with that being stated, this one was more of obviously the first fragrance, right? The first one, the OG. And this one really set the stage and the foundation of what the other fragrances were going to be after this one. And this one was made for the guy who was in a white t-shirt, black leather jacket, and jeans. So that's your casual daytime scent. Along with that, some people complained about the performance on that one. So they decided to come out in 2019 with Why Live. Now, Why Live was a good fragrance that overall that took it from daytime to nighttime, and it played that catch-all fragrance spot that you didn't have to switch from the EDT to the EDP. You could just go live from daytime to nighttime and be ready to go. But today, as I stated in the beginning, I went all of that through just to get to this here. We're talking about this one, which is YO Fresh, which was set out to kind of eliminate some of the problems that we were having with the original. Now, some people out there talked about the longevity of this one and the scent profile. So let's see if they had opportunity to correct it with this one. Now, obviously, if you look at these bottles, they look totally different in terms of the color profile, right? So you have this gradient feel on the YO Fresh. You got the white top, which is different amongst all of the other fragrances within the collection, but I think it's dope. Honestly speaking, I wouldn't have been surprised if they would have named this thing Freeze, as a lot of some of these other companies has, because it looks like it has a frozen type of feel on the bottle. As they say, it's supposed to give you that icy feel, and it definitely does with this white bottle. Now, the note breakdown between the original and this one has changed just a bit. In the EDT, you have bergamot, sage, and cedarwood as your main notes. And then in Eau Fresh, you have lemon, geranium, and cedarwood. So that cedarwood did carry over as some of the key notes within the fragrance, but there are also a lot of other notes within this one as well. Some of your other notes in this fragrance are going to include mint, you're gonna have juniper berry, you're gonna have ginger, and you're also gonna have some lavender among other notes as well. But those are just some of the key players as it comes to the fresh fragrance. Now, why Eau Fresh was made to really be able to compete as a fragrance in the spring and summertime, to really stand out during those warmer days. Now, there was lemon in the original Why fragrance, but with this one, the Why Eau Fresh, they really decided to amp that up a bit. And I think that they did that in a good way, because sometimes the lemon notes within fragrances a bit kind of make them smell like household cleaning agents. But this one, it's not that way at all. They really did a good job of amping up the lemon note while still making this a refined scent. In addition to that lemon, you have that geranium, and then you also have that cedarwood to really give it a nice earthy undertone as it begins to dry down from that citrus blast in the beginning, which really gives you this nice, fresh, cool, bold type of feeling. Now, although there is some mint listed as a note within this fragrance, I don't get a fragrance that is minty, so don't really confuse that. You get some freshness here, and I think that mint probably adds toward that freshness, as you're gonna need something that gives you some nice type of, you know, refreshing feel when you're doing those dog days of summer. Now, another thing that I would say that the Wild Fresh version does versus some of the other ones within the fragrance collection is to really tone down how synthetic this fragrance smells. So I think that in the EDT, the original, it was a really sharp note, and I can't really pull it out, but maybe some type of aldehyde note. It was super sharp, and that translated across the other fragrances. Now, it was getting to get toned down more and more as you go through the fragrance line, but this one here, it's really dialed down a bit. Now, I don't have any of the inside secrets of what the actual fragrance concentration that they use for this one here, but it is listed as an EDT, although the name speaks Eau Fraîche. Now, we've also seen other companies do this with Versace Man Eau Fraîche, where it's not really a fresh concentration, it's just more so the name in itself. So I would imagine they've probably taken down the fragrance oil concentration just a bit, maybe a percentage or two, three or four, but maybe not enough to really hit that or fresh type of feel. So I think this one is a good fragrance overall, especially for the spring and summer. In terms of performance, this one is okay. I think the performance on this one, for what I would expect from, you know, a fragrance of this type of caliber, 5 to 7 hours is what I get with this one, which I would say is okay, about moderate for what you would get. In terms of projection, I would say for about the first hour or so, you're gonna get 2 to 3 feet, and then it kind of tones itself back in a bit for maybe a foot or so. But this one is a good, you know, scent bubble, scent profile. If someone is around you and you have this fragrance on, they'll likely smell you, and in most cases, they won't dislike it. Now, personally, I won't say that I enjoy this one more than the original, because I don't, but what I will tell you is that I feel like more people will be receptive to this one than the original. Again, the original had this really type of synthetic overtone all over the fragrance here, but which kind of pushed people away from it. I think this one still has it, but it's super toned down, relatively speaking, and I think this one is going to be more easily accepted from those who may be around you when you rock this thing. Now, while Eau Fraîche, although it's a 2020 release, it's not hard to find, but I did see it on discounters earlier in the year, and it kind of flew off the shelves pretty quickly there, so you can keep your eye out, and you may be able to find it, but if you're looking for this one and you want it now, if you're out and about, you're likely able to pick this up in a store, maybe whether it's a Belk, a Macy's, a Dillard's, or something like that, or you can pick this one up online. They'll be more than happy to ship it to you if you're looking to quarantine and stay safe. This one to me is going to be a good dumb reach scent if you're out and about on a spring or summer day, especially those hot, more warmer days. It feels like 106 degrees outside. You spray this thing on and you'll be good to go. Beach attire, yes, you're good to wear this one out in the boat. I'm on the boat. You could definitely rock this one and be A-okay. So I think this is a nice offering from the house. It's one that I enjoy. I think other people out there will enjoy as well. I think this is probably one of the better designer releases for me personally in 2020 thus far. I think I put that on the list as a standout scent for 2020. That's my personal opinion, my thoughts on this thing here. I would love to know how you feel about why, whether it's this one or any of the others within the house in itself. Which one are you reaching for first? All things considered, for what this fragrance offers and how it compares to the other fragrances within the lineup of the Y series, and just what I would use this one for, I would give it a 7.5 out of 10. What are your thoughts on this? Again, I would love to know. As always, I'm your boy, Big BB, and we like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend that we are back again. And you already know what I need you to do. Just hit the goddamn bell.